This followed a concern raised by Herbert Taiwo, the Member of Parliament for Kashongi County, who unearthed figures from the Ministry of Finance's 2023-2024 ministerial policy statement, indicating that the ministry had planned to spend 2.2 billion shillings on advertising and public relations, 4.2 billion shillings in meetings and seminars, office equipment at 3 billion shillings, furnitures and fittings at 6.9 billion shillings, with the controversial expenditure items said to cost about 108.9 billion shillings.
We also found that there are some expenditures which are too much for the ministry, which is not in production. This economy is limping because we have no production services being catered for.
You now want a breakdown of the 79 billion consultancy. I think that's a big concern there. And the 1.6 billion training. And what are the area? Because that's the other ones are small. That's what you say.
Taiwo summarized expenditures according to the Charter of Accounts of the Ministry, further detailing printing, stationery, photocopying and bindery at 5.6 billion shillings, books, periodicals and newspapers at 56.2 million shillings, ICT supplies at 20.3 billion shillings, and consultancy services at a hoop of 49 billion shillings.
Clearly, these expenditures, are they efficient? Are they not exaggerated? Whatever we come back with, then we should be able to recommend to government that this is an extravagant payment here, this is an extravagant expenditure here, this should be cut. But we cannot do that when we're not given the details of how they arrived.
Godfrey Semugoma, the Acting Director of Financial Management Services at the Ministry of Finance, informed the committee that the money on seminars will go towards hosting regional budget workshops. However,
part of that money is regional workshops, regional budget workshops, which you have seen because we have publicized these events. We go out in the regions to consult on the budget.
Semugoma defended expenditure, arguing that the Ministry of Finance is a highly technical ministry and cannot do without continuous training in order to keep updated with the global trend in both financial and economic management, citing that 60 billion shillings is required for IT systems that will require training for the users.
Because we are also doing knowledge transfer, when we buy these systems, we also ensure that our people, the local people, our ministry people, are also knowledgeable on the systems.
Taiwo raised concerns regarding the actual number of staff at the Ministry of Finance, where the payroll indicated 547 staff, while another document indicated that the ministry had 154 approved positions, of which only 77 were filled. The ministry was asked to explain the discrepancies.
Number of approved positions, 154. Number of field positions, 77. The indicated staff here is 547. I needed some clarity.
But Semugoma refuted the discrepancies in figures, noting that the Ministry of Finance staff is within the approved structure.
It's overstaffed structure. You can't have it. How will you pay them? Because now I've said that we are at the forefront of automation. The salaries are also on the system. You cannot pay what you don't have.
In the 2023-2024 national budget, Ministry of Finance, Planning and Economic Development has been allocated 2.401 trillion shillings. And of this, 11.6 is for the wages. Parish development model is at 1.59 trillion shillings. Transfers to subversions is 642.99 billion shillings. Contributions to the international organizations, PFM systems, is at 12.4 billion shillings. Operations at 153.79 billion shillings. External financing is at 314.31 billion shillings. Report compiled by Fred Kajiwi for the news.